What's up, everybody, and welcome to a brand new video here at Hack Your Finances. Today, we're answering the question of where to start with your finances. And friends, it all starts with developing a financial plan. See, goals without a plan is just a wish. Let's go. For me, this is one of my favorite topics to dive into because I found that most people want to take their finances to the next level, but a majority of people do not have a written financial plan. See, CNBC even wrote an article that said that 75% of Americans are just winging it when it comes to their finances and their financial journey. Even Charles Schwab posted that 1 out of 4 Americans don't have a written financial plan, which is why today we're gonna help you develop and write a financial plan, helping set you up for success and being in front of 25% of Americans. Now, before we dive into what goes into your financial plan, I think it's important to ask the question, what isn't a financial plan? And number one, your financial plan is not a wish list. I know, I hate to tell you, but your wish list is not what a financial plan looks like of what the new thing you want to buy, the bigger house, or just the shiny new Tesla. Not only that, but your financial plan isn't just some big, crazy, lofty goal. Like, I want to be a billionaire, so flipping bad. That's not a financial plan. So if a financial plan isn't just some lofty goal or your wish list, what is it? See, Investopedia describes a financial plan as a written document that outlines where you're currently at in your financial situation, what your long-term goals are, and what strategies do you need to take to be able to get there. Now, I know that doesn't sound super exciting, and neither does a blueprint to a skyscraper, but do you know what is exciting? Standing on the 131st floor in Manhattan, looking out over New York City. Now that's exciting, which is why today we're gonna dive into developing, drafting, and writing our financial plan so that we can start charting out where we're at today and where we wanna go in the days and years to come. Studies have found that 100% of people that don't write a financial plan don't have a written financial plan. Crazy, I know. And so our first step in writing out our financial plan is to pull out a piece of paper and pencil. The first step is to determine where you're at in your financial journey. So let's keep this simple. Let's start out by drafting 3 columns on the top of our page. And we're gonna start by listing out our liabilities and our debt. Now, you're gonna hear me say this once and you're gonna hear me say it 100 times. You need to find what's gonna work for you. Some people, they love being detailed. They wanna know every single aspect of it, down to the dollar and down to the cents. For me, I'm okay just working with general averages and what I remember from my last statements. But see, this is the thing. Within this column, we wanna write out every liability and every debt that we have. So we wanna list out A, what we owe, B, what the interest rate is, and C, what the monthly payment is. If we can list out these 3 things, it'll help us see where we're at when it comes to our debt and what we still have in terms of our liabilities. Some key things that are probably gonna appear on this list are things like your home loan, any car loans that you have, credit card debt, student loans, pretty much anything that has a pending balance that isn't gonna be paid off by the end of this month, let's throw it in that column. Now, the next thing we wanna do is move to our second column, and we wanna list out all the assets that we have. So this is anything that holds or retains monetary value. Things that would go in this category are things like, what is your home worth? What is your car worth, if it's worth mentioning on there? This would be things that are like your 401k or your IRA, your savings account, your checking account, anything that would be an asset for you. And lastly, we wanna move to the third column and we wanna list out any cash flow or monthly income that we have. So for most people, this is just gonna be your monthly paycheck that you get from your job. But if you have a side hustle, if you have reoccurring income or a rental property, make sure you put it in this third column. Now, there's some items on your list that might appear in 1, 2, or maybe even 3 columns. So for example, for a rental property, if you have one, it might be something that appears on your liability side. For our rental property, we still have $80,000 that we owe on it, but it's also appearing in my assets column because it's worth roughly 130 to 140K. And then it's also gonna appear in my income column because we're making roughly $1,000 to $1,100 every month off of it. So it's okay if it's appearing in multiple categories. You just wanna make sure you have each aspect listed in its appropriate column. And now that we have this information, all we need to do is a little math. Now, hold on. I said a little math. Don't click out of the video yet. All we're gonna do is calculate two quick numbers, which is our net worth and our debt to income ratio. And to start with that, to find out your net worth, all you need to do is take your assets, add them all up, and subtract out your liabilities. And this will give you your net worth. And our second number to calculate is our debt to income ratio. All we have to do for this is add up our monthly debt liabilities. So what do we have to pay on our mortgage? What do we have to pay on our car? Add those up and divide it by our total monthly income. And this will give us our debt to income ratio. Now, this is what I'll tell you. Banks are generally looking for you to have below 36% for your debt to income ratio. But this is my encouragement. Don't make that your target. Make your 20s or even high teens a great target for your debt to income. Now that's all the math we're gonna do for today. But now that we have these numbers, it starts giving us a clear picture of where we're at today so we can start charting out a course for where we wanna be in the years to come. And our next step is to start setting goals as we look towards the future of where we wanna be in 1 year, 5 years, and 10 years down the road. Now, I know for some people that might sound daunting of starting with 1 year, 5 year, and 10 years. And this is what I'd say. If this is your first time charting out your financial plan, maybe start with 1 year, 3 years, and 5 years. So right now, when you close your eyes and when you start picturing where you wanna be in the next year and years to come, start thinking about some of those goals that you wanna set. Maybe it's getting out of debt or paying off that student loan. Maybe for you, it's increasing your generosity from 10% to 15%. For some people, it's gonna be increasing their 401k contributions, or maybe it's diversifying their investments into real estate. There's no bad ideas as we develop this first draft for our goals and where we wanna be. Now, something to keep in mind though, is thinking about where you're at today and where you wanna be, and making sure that you're setting appropriate timelines for that. I see this happen so often where people say, I wanna be out of debt in 1 year, but when they add up what they owe, it's almost 3 or 4 times what they make in the entire year. As you can tell, the math doesn't quite check that out. Now, before we finalize our financial goals, I think it's always great and important to ask the question, why? What's my why behind my what and what I want to accomplish? And this is what I found from fitness goals, finance goals, or just goals for your future. In the moment you can establish a why behind your what, a purpose that's greater than you, then you can begin to establish some of the core values or principles. It helps you be able to chart out a long-term course, because everybody wants to set great goals. Everybody wants to lose 10 pounds. Everybody wants to be rich in the future. But most people haven't established the why behind their what, so that when things get difficult, when they wanna have a cheat day, when they don't wanna invest, or they wanna buy that new shiny car, they don't have those values, they don't have that purpose to stand upon and to make sure they can keep charting on their course. So find out what that is for you. Maybe it's being generous like never before. Maybe for you, it's building out a legacy for your family or for your kids in the years to come. No matter what your why is, find your why, write it down, and begin to chart out your course. And now that you've written down your 2 to 3 values or your purpose, the greater why behind your what, I encourage you to look over what you wrote down for your 1 years, your 3 years, and your 5 year plan, and ask the question, does my purpose, does my why, is it seen in the midst of the goals that I'm setting and where I wanna go? Because it's those questions that are gonna help you be able to run the race with endurance. Because in a year, when you wanna buy that new, nice, shiny car, it's that driving factor, it's that purpose, it's that why that's gonna help you say no so that you can make decisions in the short term that aren't always easy, but will build a beautiful, bright future in the long run. Our last and final step is to take everything that we've written down and start asking the question, what adjustments and changes do we need to make over the next 3 months and 6 months so that we can obtain and conquer our 1 year goal? So maybe that looks like readjusting your budget so you can more aggressively pay off debt. Maybe it's actually starting your investing journey by clicking the link below in the description and downloading Webull, depositing $100, and getting one free stock worth up to $1,400. Hey, if it's you and you want to get into real estate investing, maybe it's asking the question, what books or podcasts do I need to listen to and read so that I can begin to prepare for those financial goals that I have out in front of me? See, this is what I found. No matter what your goal is, there are practical next steps that you can take and need to take if you want to accomplish your goals. So friends, step number one, pull out a piece of paper and pencil and start writing your financial plan. Step number two is to begin to list out your assets, your liabilities, and your monthly cash flow or income. Step number three, you begin to write out the goals that you have for 1 year, 3 years, and 5 years down the road. This helps chart out the course and what tangible goals you want to accomplish in the years to come. And step number four, we want to establish our why, our values, and our purpose behind what we're doing in our finances. See, this is what I found. Is purpose produces passion, and passion produces change. And step number five is to determine what your action items are after writing down this plan so you can figure out what you need to do over the next 3 months and 6 months to be able to crush that 1 year goal. And lastly, I want to leave you with this financial hack when it comes to developing and walking out your financial plan. And it's to not do the journey alone. Man, this is what I found. Anytime that I have somebody that knows where I'm going, that I've set my goals, whether it's my fitness, my finances, or just my future, somebody helping, keeping me accountable, cheering me along, and helping encourage me to crush those goals helps move the needle so much. So I encourage you, if you've written out this financial plan, make sure you share it with somebody. Share this video and say, hey, let's build out our financial plans and run the journey together. Man, what a massive life hack and financial hack helping you meet the goals that you want to accomplish over the next year, 3 years, and 5 years to come. Well, hey, I hope you've enjoyed today's video. Make sure you hit subscribe, smash that like button, and spread the word as we hack your finances, posting brand new videos every Thursday. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next time. Peace.